Okay, good morning. So we looked at the pseudo-adiabatic chart in the last two classes, and we tried to solve some problems using the pseudo-adiabatic chart as well as through formulae. Then the problem was the constant theta lines and the constant temperature lines were very close to each other in the pseudo-adiabatic chart. The, as you recall, the constant temperature lines, that is isotherms or verticals, and this pseudo-adiabatic chart, the constant theta lines, that is a constant potential temperature lines, called as the dry adiabat or the pseudo adiabat. We say pseudo because that moisture has not been considered. So the one was sloping down, you recall it, is it was like this. P was in a this is T. So the funda is, this is an inverted Lorentz scale, correct? It's an inverted Lorentz scale. What is an inverted? This top is 0, bottom is 1000. We never draw like that. From childhood you have said that it is 0 to this thing. So it is inverted, but it is for convenience, because bottom represents ground, 0 represents top. So since you are always dealing with the variation of so many quantities with respect to height in the atmosphere, it is convenient for us to imagine and comprehend the situation. Okay. So the point was, these are T is equal to constant. So the T is equal to constant and this theta equal to constant are very crowded. So to overcome this, we people figured out this QT Lorentz P chart. And then we also looked at the region of interest, because for the kind of pressures and temperatures encountered in the atmosphere, there is one particular region, I think from 220 Kelvin to something, okay, and some pressure to some pressure. This is the region of interest for us even when we want to work out problems, okay, or we want to study phenomena in the atmosphere. Okay. Later on we saw that an advantage is this is the pseudo-adiabatic chart. This QT Lorentz P chart overcomes this in the sense that this inverted Lorentz P, okay, but so the x-axis is kind of fuzzy, isn't it? Because it, it's kind of fuzzy. So you have to, when you mark points on this, you have to be careful. Okay. So we saw that we wrote the equation of this pseudo-adiabatic or potential temperature, which is called the Poisson equation. Theta equal to P to the power of 0.286 or minus? Okay. Then we took Lorentz P both sides and this thing and all that, and we found out that on this chart the curve sloping downward. Okay. I'll give you the pseudo-adiabatic, sorry, this QT ln P chart. Take a look. Okay. All right. So all of you have this? Okay. So we are looking at this chart. So this is inverted ln P, correct? Trouble. I don't know why it happened. So, inverted ln P. So, please look at the isotherms. Please look at the isotherms. One isotherm, for example, okay. So, the isotherms are like this. One isotherm is, what is the problem? Okay. So, this is one isotherm. What is that isotherm? T equal to? Minus 20 degree centigrade. Is it okay? So, isobar. Okay. So, one isobar is, what is this isobar?
400
isobar. Correct. Okay. Where is the 1000 H bar? Yes. 1000 H bar is here. Okay. Where is the 100 H bar? Topmost. So, you are having between 1050 and 100. This straight line only, I do not know how to. Anyway, it is still making sense. So, 100 H bar. Okay. Now, can you spot the dry adiabats, theta equal to constant lines?
Let me show you. I am using the magenta. So, these are the dry adiabats. Okay.
So, those are the theta equal to constant. Okay. How are they going? So, this is theta equal to okay. All right. So, you are going up, it is a decreasing pressure from bottom to top. The isotherms are skewed by 45 degrees, that is why this QT, it is inverted ln P, so that is why it is a QT ln P chart. Okay. Most of the actions which are taking place in the atmosphere for the pressures and temperature which you normally encounter are latecomers can, we can, one of you come and you don't cross the camera. You can keep something, Rohan, keep a few on your desk. Okay. All right. But there are some more things which we have to see,
which I will just show. I will allude to this now, but after we flesh out the definitions only, you will understand what these are. We will choose some other color. There is something called the saturation adiabat.
They are also sloping downwards, but the nature of the curve is different from that of the dry adiabat, correct? Okay. And then we have one more set of lines, which are the saturation mixing ratio. Okay. So, it is a really involved chart where how many quantities are there? How many kinds of curves or lines are there? 5. Isobar, isobar, isotherm, dry adiabat, saturation adiabat, saturation mixing ratio. I come again, there are 5 quantities in this chart, isobars, isotherms, dry adiabat, saturation adiabat, saturation mixing ratio. Out of these 5, isobar, isotherm, dry adiabat, you already know. So, what you do not know right now is saturation mixing ratio and saturation adiabat. Even for this, we can write the formulae. We will start with the formulae, and these are incorporated as lines, and it is very comprehensive. You can choose to solve the problems either by using formulae, or quickly you can solve any of these problems using the charts. Just like that aircraft cabin air problem, we solved by using both the chart and the formula. Using the chart will be little bit faster, but it will be less accurate.
Sir,
yeah.
Those dry adiabats are drawn over here.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Sir, like there is a confusion as to like which one. Which side is faulty? Which side is faulty? Which side is
positive? You can see.
Which side is faulty?
Which side is positive? As it go to the right, it is positive. Correct. As you go to the right, it is positive. Okay. Okay, for the benefit of the question was that minus is not clear, so when you go to the right, it is positive. All right? Okay. Shall we proceed? So, we have to now consider water vapor in air. So, we have to now flesh out some terminologies or definitions concerning moisture parameters. Okay. So, mixing ratio. Mixing ratio omega is given by the ratio of the mass of the water vapor to the mass of dry air. Okay. So, what is the maximum content of moisture in the atmosphere when we saw in the earlier table? 5%, no? Of the order of 5%, right? Or 10%? 5%. So kg by kg, is it a good unit? Kg of vapor divided by kg of dry air, is it a good unit? What is a better unit? Grams. Grams of water vapor by kg of air, that is a good unit. In 1 kg of air, how many grams? That is decent. You will say 5 grams, 4 grams, 10 grams. Kg means 0.000, it will, you will miss one point and 0 and then go wrong. Okay, it is not an appropriate unit. Therefore, mass of water vapor, grams, mass of dry air in kg. This is called mixing ratio. How much water vapor is mixed along with the dry air? So, the total mass of air is md plus mv, please remember. Correct? Specific humidity, that is the next quantity. So, I will skip this. Denoted by the symbol phi, some people call it as phi, let us call it as phi. I would prefer the bracket, but if you are comfortable without the bracket in the denominator, that is also okay, so long as you do not get confused. Okay. So, the specific humidity is the mass of the water vapor divided by the total mass of air, which is mass of dry air plus mass of water vapor. So, it is slightly different from mixing ratio. Now, I will give you 1 minute, please convert the specific humidity formula in terms of the mixing ratio. Or invariably, therefore, phi is approximately equal to omega. Means the numerical value of the specific humidity, the numerical value of the mixing ratio are nearly close to each other, they are indistinguishable. Please solve this problem. Problem number 26. Problem 26. If air contains water vapor with a mixing ratio of 6 grams per kilogram, if air contains water vapor with a mixing ratio of 6 grams per kilogram and the total pressure is 1030 hPa, calculate the vapor pressure PV, calculate the vapor pressure PV. I come again for those people who missed. If air contains water vapor with a mixing ratio of 6 grams per kilogram and the total pressure is 1030 hpa, calculate the vapor pressure. I will just write the mixing ratio is what? Omega. Question is, what is the vapor pressure? Just take 5 minutes, I will take attendance so that we can do parallel processing. Ranjit Kumar, K. Vinay, Vivek Kumar, Akhil, Bal Kumar, V. K. Deepak, Ashwin, Srivastava, Srivatsava, Amrita, Gautam, Lakshmikant, Digvijay, Sai Sneha, Rajesh, Rishita, Venu, Piyush, Sai Chan, Ruturaj, Vivek Kumar Gupta, Chaitanya Ravindra, Sai Pavan, Daniel Akash, Kaita Deepak, Rohan, Vivek Siddharth, Vivek Siddharth, Nimit, Noel Jose, Ranjit, Rohit Tomar, Udit, Viswajit Bhatt, Arun Kumar, Anubhav, Amit Soni, Arpan Das, Divyashri, Saujanya, Aditya, Anusha, Maurya, Mohit Reddy, Bhargavi, Sai Rahul, Sanjay, Marius, Ajayendra, Vivek Harb. Done? What is the vapor pressure? 9.9. Let me check. That's quite good. How many of you still doing? Just raise your hands. Any problem? Where are you getting stuck? Is somebody clueless? Shall I solve? Shall I solve with the board? Okay. So, the partial pressure is the number of moles of the vapor plus the number of moles of dry air plus number of moles of the vapor into the total pressure. Okay. So, the total pressure is given. So, now this number of moles is nothing but mass of this thing by MW, molecular weight of water vapor, divided by mass of dry air by molecular weight of dry air plus mass of water vapor divided by molecular weight of water vapor to P. Okay. Everything is given. You can straight away solve it. I have actually simplified it further. Can we write it as PV? What further simplification is possible? Or you are just doing 6 by 18, you are doing that, is it? Huh? 6 by 18. Okay, do that. 6 by? By? Plus? Actually, it comes to 9.84 hPa. Correct? In kilopascal? We call it as, it's nearly 1 kPa. What is PV by P? Correct? It's very small, right? Huh? Inference. But some funda is there. We will make it little bit, I want to generalize this. Mw by Md is? Epsilon, right? Huh? Just do a quick 2-minute exercise. Put this in terms of omega and epsilon. A quick exercise. People who have completed problem number 26, just write the formula in general term in terms of omega and epsilon. The question is clear? Okay. Just to look for generalization, okay? I will clean up this side. What do you want to do? Yeah. Now, what are the steps? You are dividing throughout by MV by MW, is it? Okay. So, MV will come here. You are dividing both the numerator and denominator by? Yes, 1. Is quite all right. Okay. Huh? 1 by? Epsilon by omega plus omega, epsilon plus omega, omega. Huh? Okay. Another smart way of doing it. Fine? So, mixing ratio 6 is given. That is point. 6 means you have to take it as 0.006, huh? Don't take it as 6, it will cup. So, 0.006 0.006 plus 0.622, that will be in the denominator, 1 divided by 0.628, is it correct? No, 0.006 divided by 0.628 into 1030, you will get this, all right. Problem 27. Calculate the virtual temperature correction. Calculate the virtual temperature correction for moist air. Calculate the virtual temperature correction for moist air at 32 degree centigrade. Calculate the virtual temperature correction for moist air at 32 degree centigrade that has a mixing ratio of. Calculate the virtual temperature correction for moist air at 32 degree centigrade that has a mixing ratio of 22 grams per kilogram. Okay, that has a mixing ratio of 22 grams per kilogram. Given moist air, for moist air omega is 22 grams per kilogram, T is 32 degree centigrade. Question is TV minus T. We have seen that for all kinds of situations, dry air, hottest atom, TV minus T does not very less, does not exceed a few degree centigrade. If you get some 40 or 50 degree centigrade, please revisit your answer or revisit your calculation. So you will get an answer which is a few degree centigrade. That few could be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 that you solve now. Okay. Now, after defining this mixing ratio and so on, that saturation adiabat and saturation mixing ratio we have to define, and then we have to again go back to this chart. It is already messed up. So, we will take a new chart and consider these lines. 4, correct, it is 4. I got it as 4.1. Yeah, that is okay, around 4. Rohan? Amrita? Solving? Rohit Tomar? You have the calci? Cell phone, okay. Four, 3.9. People who already completed, do the next exercise, put it in general, put it as a general formula which can be used later on without the numericals, without the values, epsilon by omega and all that. What happened, you got it? What about you, Sai Rahul? Your formula is there.
Formula for difference?
Or TV by T. Whatever. How many of you are stuck? Just try, give it a shot. write the formula for TV. Correct? Rahul, you have to start from here. Now, Honda is from the previous problem, PV equal to omega by substituting for PV by P. What? 1? 1 plus. I won't stop here. I will agonize it further. Agreed. Therefore, again you can cross multiply and simplify. Let's do that. Yeah, please help me. Please tell me TV. After all that, clean up all that. What do you get? Omega plus epsilon. Plus?
Minus?
Nothing gets cancelled? Huh? Okay, so okay, we'll leave him like this. Yeah. Chaitanya, what you can do is you can use this approximation, work out. You need not use this approximation. Stop here. Find out what is TV minus T. Do approximation level A, level B, level C, and find out what is the difference. Now, let us shove in all the values. TV 32, huh? You are converting to Kelvin, right? 3 knot. Not 4.1. So what is the learning which has taken place? What is the further learning which has taken place in the last few classes as compared to chapter 1 is, though we got the formula for virtual temperature correction, from moisture parameters we are able to calculate the same thing because we are able to link up the ratio of PV by P to the moisture parameter. So you do not require the pressure at all. If you know the moisture parameters, you can play with them and get virtual temperature. Once you get virtual temperature, you can put Z2 minus Z1 to RTV by G into ln of P2, all that, so you can start working out. Okay, so this specific humidity and mixing ratio are big time, they are a big deal because they let you work out problems by ignoring this pressure, number of moles, all those things are all gone. You work out problems based on this, right. So the next would be to figure out this saturation adiabat and saturation mixing ratio. What do you think will be the, conceptually what could be saturation mixing ratio? We will define formally in the next class, we have got only a couple of minutes. Mass of water vapor when the air parcel is saturated compared to the mass of dry air, okay. So the saturation mixing ratio must be more than generally the mixing ratio, correct? Correct. So this saturation mixing ratio, we should be in a position to calculate the saturation mixing ratio. If we have to calculate the saturation mixing ratio, we have to define a new quantity called the dew point temperature. And then first we have to find out what is saturation, okay. So let us just start, I will just give a conceptual framework and then we will get into this in the next class. Consider a beaker of water, consider a container of water. Let it be a particular temperature T, okay. Now there will be some water vapor here because there will be some evaporation even at that temperature. It need not boil. So what will happen is there will be some water which is evaporating and becoming water vapor. And the reverse condensation will also take place, okay. These two fluxes need not be balanced, okay. As slowly the evaporation increases, the vapor pressure here also increases. So the condensation, the reverse condensation also increases. So at one particular stage, whatever is going up will be exactly equal to whatever is recondensing. So now what was T and PV has become T and PS. That PS is called the saturation. Is it okay? Consider a small box, the floor of which is occupied by water, a plain sheet of water at temperature T. Initially we assume that it is completely dry. there is no water vapor here. Then there is a pressure difference. The water vapor, so normally it will start evaporating. Once it starts evaporating, the partial pressure of the water vapor begins to rise in the top half, in the top of this, okay, at the same temperature itself, okay, bubbling will take place. Then what happens is the rate of condensation is less than the rate of evaporation. So this rate of the continuously the pressure will build up, the vapor pressure will build up on the top half. One stage will come when the reverse condensation is the same as the rate of evaporation, then the water is said to be completely saturated. Okay. So the water vapor, not water, the water vapor is completely saturated. So we say the humidity, relative humidity has reached. Actually, I have to define relative humidity. Relative humidity will reach 100%. That's why you say it is very sweaty, it is humid. That means it is just about to rain in the atmosphere. So it is fully saturated, it is fully laden with water. So if it is fully laden with water, it is an air parcel, all these things are conglomerating, it is forming a cloud. It just requires a little bit, it rises. You know there is a lapse rate in the atmosphere. When it rises a little bit, it is full of moisture, it will start crying. So it will rain. Okay? But everything may happen, there may be big wind. So the clouds may form in one place, the rain may go to some other place. Or suddenly something will happen, they may just break up. So on many days you see it is dark and cloudy, rain is not happening. There some trigger is there, correct? But if regular convective activity, see if it is very, very hot during the day, particularly in Kerala, people from Kerala will know, evening there will be heavy rain in many other places, for example in Chennai, if you know it is very, very hot, there is a good chance that there will be a thunder shower in the evening. So the breeze brings the rain clouds into the land. Okay? So now we will define saturation mixing ratio, relative humidity. What is the connection between these two? Go to this QT-Lonnpy chart, identify all this and start solving problems using this QT-Lonnpy chart.